Rebecca Vardy was born February 1982. She's known for I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here from 2002, Celebrity Gogglebox 2019, and Sky Sports World Championship Boxing 1989. She's been married to Jamie Vardy since May 25th, 2016. She is an English media personality married to the football player Jamie Vardy. In 2022, she lost a well-publicized libel case against Colleen Rooney, dubbed the Agatha Christie trial. It was determined that Vardy did play a role in leaking fabricated stories about Rooney to The Sun, a British tabloid. Vardy was born in Norwich, and in a variety of interviews, most recently in 2020, claimed she had been forced to grow up too soon after being abused as a child and made homeless at 15. Gee, what could have caused that? On May 16, 2023, the Channel 4 documentary, Rebecca Vardy, Jehovah's Witnesses and Me, she revealed she'd been abused by an individual in the Jehovah's Witnesses community of which she used to be a member. The Daily Mail UK says that in Rebecca Vardy's childhood home, there were no birthdays or Christmases. Television and books were censored. She was warned that youthful mischief or bad manners would bring down the wrath of God on her. As a Jehovah's Witness, she could not invite other children back to play or sing hymns in her school assembly. Modesty was practiced to the extent she went through puberty without being told how her body worked. Her life and that of her extended family was governed by all-powerful elders who sat in judgment with the right to cast people out of their closed community. Such was the dread of these men that when Rebecca told her mother she'd been sexually abused from age of 12, it was hushed up for fear, she believes, of bringing shame on the family. Now the wife of Leicester City star Jamie Vardy, mother of five, is revealing the extraordinary and painful past in a Channel 4 documentary, and it already aired. The 41-year-old is taking the role of reporter in front of the camera, interviewing other former Jehovah's Witnesses and attempting to confront the movement. At their 150 million, that's British pounds, UK headquarters in Essex. I call it a cult, she says, speaking exclusively to the Mail on Sunday. People are manipulated, brainwashed, it's coercive behavior, and it's handed down from generation to generation. Once you're in it, it's so hard to see the bigger picture, which is that it's wrong and immoral. I spent my childhood fearful, being told we were going to die in Armageddon if we didn't pray enough. I felt I had to constantly strive for perfection so that God would not be angry with me. In Oxfordshire, Rebecca was abused by a man known to the family but not a Jehovah's Witness. Over a span of 3 years, she confided to her mother, who turned to a witness elder for guidance. It was suggested to Rebecca. She merely misinterpreted the affectionate touching. She says in the documentary, "What happened to me during my childhood still affects me every single day. From the age of around 12 years old, I was being abused. Instead of being supported, I was blamed, manipulated into believing it wasn't the best thing to take it to the police. I told my mom about the abuse that I was experiencing and she cried. But she didn't believe me," she told numerous members of the Jehovah's Witnesses community. The program about her being a former JW, as I said, it already aired on the BBC, but it is bringing awareness to this organization that normally the general public usually ignores. Now ex-JWs and current JWs alike should thank Rebecca for telling her story. She's using her celebrity to tell the truth about the JWs and how it is a dangerous cult. Other celebrities only praise the organization, or, oh gee, they're guilty, oh, we left, oh, but we were raised really great in the organization. But we need more public figures like her to speak out against the organization. Why? Because that's the truth about the society that everyone covers up. Most celebrities are afraid to ostracize any community because it means dollars and cents for themselves. They need a fan base. They don't want to tick anyone off. But Rebecca is brave enough to speak her truth, and it's the truth of a lot of Jehovah's Witnesses. The society covers up CSA. If you haven't checked out Rebecca and her story, I encourage you to take some time this weekend. Educate yourself on the real story behind the smiles at those kingdom halls, as so many children suffer in silence because they have no choice. And those kids become adults and struggle with the damage that's been done to them for the rest of their lives.
I grew up very aware of what we were being taught. I'm very afraid. What happened to me during my childhood still affects me every single day. From the ages of around 12 years old, I was being abused. And instead of being supported, I was blamed, manipulated into believing it wasn't the best thing to take it to the police. I spent the first 15 years of my life as a Jehovah's Witness. Now, I want to know how this organization was able to control my family and to finally get answers to the questions I've had my whole life.